want reality TV? Follow us as we show you the side of police chase videos you normally don't see. Wild Arrest, Kamikaze Crooks, and some of the most intense moments caught on video. Next on Hot Pursuit. It's been proven time and time again that standing on the side of a busy highway is just asking for trouble. But when cops have to pull someone over, they don't often have a choice. The best a cop can do in this situation is be ready to jump. Luckily for this police officer, he's been putting in extra hours at the gym. When he realizes that there's a huge flatbed truck headed straight for him, his only chance is to vault right over the top of the car he's just pulled over. Most people know better than to mess around with the cops. But every so often, police come across criminals who aren't intimidated by the uniform, the gun, or the officer. Take this routine traffic stop here, for example. It starts in a relatively civilized manner. But watch as the officer gets the driver out of the vehicle to handcuff him. He decides that he's going to fight the power. Policemen are trained in hand-to-hand combat, so it shouldn't be too hard to apprehend this guy. But it is. It takes a few minutes of pushing, shoving, and spinning around before this cop decides it's time to get serious. He employs several precision techniques. The hold-on-tight method, the over-the-leg technique, and the over-the-hood method. But he still doesn't have control over the suspect. In fact, it's not until this complete stranger joins in the action that the officer finally makes some progress. Combining their power, the officer and his new assistant manage to get the troublemaker on the ground, where the trooper finally cuffs the suspect. Another bystander even stops by to lend moral support. Now that all the hard work is finished, official backup arrives on the scene and shows the original officer how it's done. It's quite common for people to overreact when they're being pulled over for speeding. But check out the guy in the car ahead. He's a ticking time bomb of fury. The irritable finger drumming on the roof of the car here is a clear early warning sign. But the officer at the scene doesn't notice and casually moves towards the seething suspect.
You want to roll down your window, sir? You know why I stopped you? What's that?
At first, the only trouble seems to be a bit of a communication problem.
All right.
But it's obvious this guy has deeper issues, as his rearview mirror becomes a victim of his pent-up rage. To make sure the cops know he's in a bad mood, he rips up some random pieces of paper and throws them out the window. Now he's guilty of littering, too. And the cop has some harsh words for him.
Tell you what, sir. If you don't get out and pick all this stuff up, I'm going to give you a citation for...
Leave my...
You got a problem, sir?
The trooper looks on as the angry litter bug stomps around, picking up his garbage. Up until this point, the officer has been very patient, but Mr. Furious just doesn't seem to appreciate it and treats him to another incoherent outburst.
Oh, thank you, back there. That ain't my $100 bill, you...
Tell you what, sir, this is your first warning right now, okay? You got some over here, too.
And while the officer runs the man's license over the radio...
...numerous priors, left entry speed violation 95.
The suspect blatantly gives him the finger. Even then, the cop doesn't break his cool.
Hey, sir, I need your signature right here on the side of the citation. Not admitting any guilt, just that you're receiving a copy of the citation and that you'll either appear in court or pay the fine.
The moral of this story is this. If you ever find yourself getting stopped by the cops,
all right, sir,
it's probably not a good idea to speak to him like this.
You got a problem, sir?
Because not all cops are as calm and collected as this guy.
Hey, what, sir? This is your first warning right now.
This guy doesn't need to steal anything or kill anyone to get the attention of the police. A simple case of reckless driving should do the trick. He grinds along the highway median, squeezes dangerously between vehicles with inches to spare, plows his way through deep puddles, and drives half on the shoulder and half on the grass. With driving skills like these,
oh, he's gonna hit that car. Oh.
It's just a matter of time before he gets stopped. Either by the police or by an oncoming truck. With his vehicle out of commission, he takes off on foot to get away and hides right underneath the police helicopter. Eventually, the cops nab him and he's carted off to a place where he can hide for a very long time. Next on Hot Pursuit, a drunk driver decides to toy with the cops and somebody gets blown up. On this snowy Ohio highway, cops have pulled over this man on suspicion of drunk driving. And when he's administered a series of sobriety tests, the cops are less than impressed with his performance.
You're not doing very good on my test.
So they decide it's time to take it.
Okay, well, turn around, put your hands behind your back. You're under arrest.
But the drunk guy has other plans.
Get out of the road. Get out of the road.
He plays a little game with the two officers.
Get out of the car!
And then runs drunkenly into the freezing blizzard.
He's running across the road!
Later, the man returns to have some more fun.
Get off the road! Get down on the ground!
But this time, the cops are tired of games. They pull out their pepper spray and spray him thoroughly in the face. To no one's surprise, his Bruce Lee Tiger-style kung fu is no match for getting maced. But this guy seems to think it's all just a game. He even tries to get back in his vehicle. But the keys are nowhere to be found. And when he knocks off the officer's hat, things really start to get serious. So this officer ditches the pepper spray in favor of a more convincing deterrent.
Get down on the ground!
But even this has little effect.
On the
off camera, the drunk guy assaults a passerby.
Keep going! Go! Go!
At which point, the cop upgrades his weapon of choice one more time. And the troublemaker is finally taken in.
Subject secured in handcuffs and shot.
This drunk flunked his test.
You're not doing very good on my test.
And decided to have a little fun in games. But he went one step too far. And the cops had no choice but to resort to extreme measures.
570 is fine. Subject secured in handcuffs and shot.
Sometimes the most difficult part of a traffic stop is getting a suspect to actually exit his vehicle. And it's even harder to handcuff him and get him into the back of the cruiser. But every now and then, police come across a suspect who presents no challenge at all. For instance, this guy. We're guessing he must be really claustrophobic. Driving around with his door wide open. Or perhaps it's just part of a devious plan. Watch as he gets around the next corner and tumbles out of his vehicle. But the police officer here isn't fazed by the man's unorthodox escape route.
Get on the ground now!
Get down on the ground now! Now!
He continues to carry out standard police procedure. Just in case this guy has some other tricks up his sleeve.
You know what? Slap your head. He's down on the ground. Get your head on the ground.
Although we're not quite sure why the officer makes this next request. Finally, backup arrives on the scene to help bring this incident to its natural conclusion. The moral of the story is this. If you've got a plan to evade the police, don't make step one opening your car door and falling out onto the road. Unless step two is really, really smart. After leading Texas cops on a high-speed wild goose chase for hours, the suspect in the car ahead suddenly blows out his tire. Sparks fly, and one of them sets fire to something underneath the vehicle.
He's on fire! He's on fire! Back off!
Unaware that his car has turned into a 100-mile-an-hour fireball, the fugitive just keeps going. Right up until the moment he loses control of the vehicle and comes skidding to a halt at the side of the road. The cops know that they must get the suspect and his passenger out of the burning wreck as soon as possible. Because it wouldn't be comfortable inside the car when this happens. It was obvious that this situation could flare up at any moment. And the cops did all they could to prevent the worst. In slow motion, we can see that these officers here got their suspect out of the ticking time bomb just fast enough to avoid a deadly situation. Luckily, no one was seriously hurt. Just a little hot and very bothered. Up next, two teenagers tumble out of their moving car, and a bystander helps out the cops with an arrest. On old TV shows, the police officers always used to travel in pairs. With two policemen to every squad car, it was easy to keep the streets clean. Sadly, there's only one officer in the cruiser pursuing this car. Which is a bit of a shame. Because when he runs off after these two young suspects...
23 to headquarters, I got two black males running northbound from Circle K.
There's no one left to stop the runaway vehicle that they bailed out of.
They ditched the car.
Which rolls its way across the highway, luckily causing no real damage on its way. But watch carefully as two other passengers surface. It appears that after the original suspects got out of the car, the police officers didn't even notice there were two more still inside it. Now they're able to just dust themselves off and stroll to freedom, with no one but the dashboard camera to watch them go. One thing that we can learn from police chase videos, it's that there are plenty of drunk drivers on the road, and the streets are never really safe. Take this guy, for example. He's just been pulled over for weaving in and out of lanes. But fear not, Deputy Humphreys from the Alabama State Police is on the scene.
Please don't
worry. Wow, man. What would I lock you up for?
Drinking.
Oh, you been drinking tonight?
Yes, sir.
Deputy Humphrey starts to initiate the standard sobriety tests for a DUI stop.
Fall backwards, okay?
Yes.
You know your ABCs?
I know part of my ABCs, right?
Okay. From the look of things, it might just be easier to cut straight to the breathalyzer.
Step on that cue to my car for me, okay?
Yes.
Deputy Humphreys gets the suspect into the back of the cruiser and turns the camera around to make sure we all get a clear view of the suspect. This guy's mullet makes him the perfect star for Humphrey's squad car confessions.
You've been arrested for DUI before? I mean,
time.
Having established a prior record, Humphreys gets the man to blow into the breathalyzer. Predictably, he doesn't do very well.
Okay, hang on, man. I think you're unsafe to operate a motor vehicle. You're under arrest.
Uh-huh. Now handcuffed, the drunken man makes a desperate plea to Deputy Humphreys.
Would you please get him out first?
I'm not going to let you go on driving under the influence, Mr. McCloud. No, sir.
Please.
Do you understand your rights?
No, sir.
What don't you understand?
Back,
okay, that don't have anything to do with what I just asked you.
Please give me a break.
It's pretty clear that if this guy can barely sit up straight, he definitely can't drive a car. Left to his own devices, the man reflects on his situation and leaves Humphreys a little something to remember him by. When the deputy returns, the hopeless hick makes one last pathetic plea for mercy.
Please give me a break, please.
But he doesn't get a break. Instead, he gets 45 days in prison and his license taken away from him again. The driver of this speeding pickup is wanted for homicide, but all attempts to stop him have failed so far. The cops try to box him in, but the suspect keeps going, taking some of the officer's fender with him in the process. Unknown to the runaway, state troopers have blocked off the entire road just ahead. So thinking he's just run into rush hour traffic, the fugitive hits the shoulder in order to beat the jam. But when it becomes clear that he's come to the end of the road, he pulls over into the grass, ditches his truck, and leaps over the fence. The suspect is fast on his feet, a lot quicker than the cops running after him. And he might have gotten away if this random bystander didn't stick his neck out, or rather, his foot, and help tackle the suspect to the ground. With a suspected murderer on the loose, the cops pull out all the stops, but it's not until a member of the public helps out that the cops can get a hold of them. Every day, highway police make sure that it's just as easy to get caught riding a motorcycle as it is driving a car, especially when that bike just happens to be stolen. It also doesn't help when a suspect decides to tailgate a police cruiser to get the officer's attention. And pulling tricky maneuvers like these might even make you an even bigger candidate for arrest. This speedster is weaving through Los Angeles traffic at up to 130 miles per hour, but the cops are determined to stop him. After all, with a chopper in the sky, there's nowhere to hide. Luckily for police, this junction appears to slow the suspect down as he stops right in the middle of a busy intersection. It appears as though he's run out of gas, and he pulls over to the side of the road. Eventually, the cops catch up, and the suspect gives himself up. Next on Hot Pursuit, a drunk driver dumps his wheels without putting the brakes on, and a runaway driver finds a huge obstacle in his way.
Next. Buckle up, America. It's Court TV's Hot Pursuit. For the first time on television, take an uncensored...
You idiot! You caused this whole thing!
Uncut.
Get on the ground! Get on the ground!
Unbelievable ride with the boys in blue.
This Michigan State policeman has just pulled over another drunk driving suspect. As the driver exits the vehicle, it takes off into the night, apparently on its own steam. And minus its driver, the car continues across the street towards a furniture shop, which can only mean one of two things. Either the vehicle has a deep-seated hatred of affordable but tasteful dining sets, or the man who is just driving it doesn't know how to put the car in park. Our money's on the latter. When focusing on the small details, sometimes it's easy to lose sight of the bigger picture, especially if the cops are right on your tail. The suspected burglar in this maroon car is grappling with this very problem. He's pretty impressive when it comes to swerving through busy LA traffic. But when faced with a large, slow obstacle like this 30-foot-long bus, he just drives straight into it. So, with his car and public transportation simultaneously removed from the equation, the suspect has to rely on his own 2 feet to finish off his escape. But this guy's failure to see the big picture strikes again as he turns around and runs straight into the arms of the waiting officers.